We're going to begin with Political Fiction Book of the Year. I've actually looked at all the entries in the whole competition. I think all of them could actually be fitted into this one category. Let me tell you who the judges were in this category.
Guardian journalist Jackie Ashley. Ex-director of communications at Number 10, Alastair Campbell. Novelist and former Tory MP, Edwina Curry. Deborah Mattinson, founder of Britain Thinks. And Guardian columnist Zoe Williams.
Wow. You see, these are proper judges. These are real awards. These are awards you would want. We would like to read the memoirs of most of these people. Some of them, of course, we have read. Here to present the award, we have somebody very special indeed, one of the judges. Please welcome to the stage, Alastair Campbell.
Thank you. Well, the good news is I've lost my voice.
Shame.
However, it's tricky because I'm actually up for two awards later. And so I'll have to come back and make those speeches so as I can thank Peter Mandelson for making it all possible for me. However, I've taken a look at the judging panel. Simon Walters of the Mail on Sunday, who once called me a cross between Rasputin and Joseph Goebbels. Lord Ashcroft, whose only previous communication with me was through his lawyers in Belize. And my sparring partner from the 2010 general election, Adam Bolton. Unfortunately, it appears that Andrew Gilligan couldn't make the judging lunch. So the even better news is that this is probably the only visit I will be making to the platform tonight. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is what we call in the world of spin, pre-buttle. I don't mind this because actually the novel is now much more my genre. I intend to be back here next year as a nominee in this category, having just finished a novel about the highly political subject of alcoholism and our failure to deal with it. Politics is, however, much, much more associated with fiction, non-fiction than fiction. There is even, I can tell you this because I know that none of you have read it, a book about the political impact of Nick Clegg. David Laws has written his memoirs. Sales may one day vie with that seminal work from the Thatcher period, Norman Fowler's Ministers Decide. There we were thinking it was the bus drivers. And the Blair era, our era, has a whole library. I'm sure some of you are old enough to remember libraries, devoted to its ups and downs, most notably, of course, The Third Man. And when it comes to Sales, indeed he is. Behind our glorious leader, of course, and behind my diaries, the fourth volume of which has just been published in paperback. The nominees for this evening are...
Pawn's Gambit by Harry Armstrong, published by Arena Books. A Sentimental Traitor by Michael Dobbs, published by Simon & Schuster. Sweet Tooth by Ian McEwan, published by Jonathan Cape. The Geneva Trap by Stella Rimington, published by Bloomsbury. Skag Boys by Irvin Welsh, published by Jonathan Cape.
They were all absolutely brilliant, but the most brilliant, it's not the first time he's heard this, the winner is Ian McEwan.
Come on down, Ian McEwan.
Side, he goes in the middle.
Well, I think I'm the only one here who's read a novel by Alastair in TypeScript. So this is a return of a favor, long awaited. Thank you very much. Sweet Tooth has never won a prize before. I'm very touched. Thank you very much indeed.
Most of us in this room only ever read our novels in TypeScript. Well done, Ian. How wonderful to win a prize. And I have loved reading Alastair's diaries. I have the whole collection, they're marvelous. And I'm now reading, actually, Tony Blair's book. I've only just got round to reading A Journey, you know, Tony Blair's memoirs. Much more readable than many of you may have thought, actually. It's quite breezy. It gets a bit heavy towards the end, but the early bits are really quite breezy and fun. I'm reading it in German. I'm learning German. You never know. The title is more appealing. It's called A Journey in English, but Tony Blair's book in German is called Eine Fahrt. Anyway.